because they can give smoky aromas to the cocoa. But like I've seen all the others, depending on your energy source, what you burn, it could be okay. What we recommend, if the conditions are not adequate and you must include artificial dry, is to try just to finish with artificial drying. Just try to keep as long as possible under sun, and then just finish your drying for a few hours to around 40-50 degrees Celsius in the mass of the cocoa in an artificial dryer. So try to keep it as short as possible towards the end. Just to reduce, let's say, moisture content from 8.5% or so, 9% to 6.5%.
Yes. Is it possible to dry your cocoa artificially, using the artificial dryer without going through the fermentation process?
No. The fermentation is an individual step. So you first need to ferment your cocoa to develop your flavor precursors. You, except if you go for like non-fermented cocoa, then it's another story, it's another market. But if you want to have fermented cocoa for chocolate production, you first need to do your fermentation, and afterwards you go for the drying process.